Hey everyone, it's Dave, Display Fireworks One. Watch this little video and I'll see you at the end of the clip.
Hey everyone, Dave, Display Fireworks One. I'm still at Cobra-Con and I'm in a classroom here. I want to show you something that rarely happens, and I wish I had it on video, but I don't. This is an MJG Firewire Initiator, and I was teaching a class about firing systems. One of these accidentally went off, and I have Jeff from the company here that's at the convention, and I went and talked to him about it, and we're going to review it as a learning experience. Now I want you to look. This isn't the exact classroom, but there's two or three that are identical to this. Now the class was over and I was coming around. I had the cover on it and I had the two wires exposed. And there was a gentleman sitting like right here. I'm trying to reenact it. And it's a rare opportunity, because as Jeff and I were talking, most people that experience this are not around to tell the story. But here's how it went. He was asking me a way to connect two of these together. And I was explaining to him how to do it in series. And this was hanging like this, and it was touching that chair. There was a gentleman sitting here, and the guy I was talking to was here. And I have a piece of wire, and I touched, and I was showing him, you touch one to the other, like this, and at the same time, this guy got up, and the initiator went off. And I was in shock. I was like, it went off. So I went over this with Jeff, and we're looking at a couple theories. Now, I'm wearing all polyester right here, known for static. The end of this touched this chair, and we reenacted this and got a little spark out of it, but it's one of those things, you could do it 1,000 times. So Jeff, come a little closer. I want them to see what I did here, if it's staying in focus. Now see, what this is a wire I had, and I touched one like this, and I held it, and I was explaining to him. Now this one was out, and the cover was on. Now, what do you think happened here, Jeff?
Well, what I think happened is the combination of your shirt, this plastic chair, I think the static charge went through your hand, down the wire, and jumped through the match head into the chair.
Okay.
I would love to get a hand on the actual igniter, because I bet you that the static electricity itself set off the chemical and didn't explode the bridge wire.
Okay, so the static charge arced.
Absolutely.
Like to simplify, arced on the chair, and that's what set that charge on.
Exactly. As when you get static electricity on the doorknob, you watch it jump from your fingertip to the doorknob. Well, it used this initiator as a path to get to the chair. And when it jumped through the igniter head into the chair, that's when it set off the chemical.
But we're reenacting this for you, because I look for these learning opportunities. I only wish I had it on video as it happened.
Yeah.
Now, the guy getting up next to me may or may not have had an influence. I don't think he did. But it was like he got up, I did this, and it, the match head went off. Now, these are the non-regulated ones. Now, if you know, I hope Jeff agrees with this, but the same cautionary things with regulated electric match apply to these. Would that be correct?
Absolutely.
Yeah, okay.
They are less sensitive to impact and friction, but they are still sensitive. And as far as static electricity goes, your body can produce enough amperage and volts to set off an igniter.
If you're new at this, it takes very, very little voltage to set that off.
A double-A battery.
Yeah, little tiny battery will do that. But as soon as it happened, the word made it back to Jeff, and I wanted to, you know, go over it with him, because it's a great learning opportunity. And believe it or not, of all these years I've been in this, that's the very first time it's ever happened.
You could do this test another 1,000 times, and you may not duplicate the situation.
I mean, I wire barge shows for 3 days, but the right combination. Well, this, never wear polyester to do a fire.
Never wear polyester. Yeah. Never use a plastic chair.
Yeah.
If there was carpeting on this floor, we would be in the perfect scenario of what not to do.
Yeah. Well, anyway, no reflection on the product. It's still a great product, you know. So just wanted to relive that and show it to you, because I'm sure it's making it through the rumor mill. And I look for this kind of stuff. You know, I'm actually glad it happened to me and glad we're all safe, because it's a great learning opportunity for someone new. After all these years, it's given me a new respect for it too, after seeing it. It does happen. And when you hear about accidents in an electric match and whatever it is, this is probably how it happens. Static electricity. What do you think, static? I probably Absolutely. Should have saved that match. You know,
if you can get a hold of it,
yeah,
we have to take a look.
We're going to have to try to track it down.
Yeah.
All right, everyone, that's the story. You heard it right from the horse's mouth. And I brought in MJG Jeff.
The second horse.
The second horse's mouth. We're having a good time here at Cobra-Con, and it's a great learning opportunity. I hope you enjoyed it too. Thank you.
Hey, everyone. I hope you enjoyed that video. Let me try and show you in a little more detail on what happened, and explain the principle of shunting an electric match or an initiator. Now, what I was showing a gentleman at Cobra-Con in the class, to show you in more detail, he asked, how do you connect two initiators, or for the purpose of this, we'll just call it all electric match, together, and to shoot them at the same time? Now, you have two choices. You could put them like this together, and then put those two into the firing system, or you connect it in series, it's called, like this. So I hope you could see that. And what I was showing him was, I didn't even have them connected, but I exposed this, and I was talking, and the end of the match came down and touched the chair, and somehow the current from my, we're assuming the polyester shirt I had on, went down and set the match off. This is how accidents happen, right? So with this, you at least see how this works. And this would go into, you could probably put another one on. So you take the left and right and connect it and do probably three of these. Now, let's explain shunting to you if you're new at this. If you do not have an ATF license, you're probably buying this. This one is a traditional run-of-the-mill Chinese electric match. And this is a vintage electric match Davy Fire. Now, you know, this is the one, if you've been following my videos, I whine about all the time that I miss. Okay, let's look at the, now what we mean by shunting is the end of the wires are touching. And I'll show you this with a battery when I'm done here. If the end of the wires are touching, you know, the theory is the current can't go down and set this charge off. Now, these are also prone to shock. If you hit these with a hammer, it'll go just like a cap. Now, you know, the properties of this are the properties of this. They, you know, and then people will say, well, you know, how did he get this approved not to be whatever? And I guess that's his secret. But so, you know, just because you bought these without a license doesn't mean they're any safer than the regulated ones. Now, let's look at the Chinese one. This is the one you'll see pretty common out there. How do they shunt? Now, let's look at that. See if I can get close on this. You see what they do? They just twist it. The problem with this is now it's this. And now it's not this. It's just pretty easy to, you know, unshunt it. So you go like this. Now it's shunted. Now you could, you know, if you bump it, is it still, you know, you look at an angle, is that still shunted? It looks like it is, you know, but is it or isn't it? See, that's the Chinese one. Now on the initiators, and I think this company that makes these does the same on their regulated ones. This is a little more shunted, so to speak. See how this has this cover, and they took it one step further. See if it would have just gone like this, too easy to slip off. But see, they put that on and bend it. Now it's going to be a little harder to come off. So even if it comes off, it may still be shunted. See? They actually look like a... Put some little twist on it or not, I don't know. And then you, when you separate them, that's when the potential for something happening. Yeah, they twisted it a little bit. And then you split the wires and put it on your system. Okay, that's kind of their technique. Now to me, this is the gold standard electric match, and it always will be. Davy Fire, this one's old, took it one step further, see? They put this nice cap on there. But I'll be honest with you, there were times thinking back on pro shows, this cap, you'd open a box of these and some of the caps would be at the bottom of the box. And just touching. You know, when they make these, I'm sure it's a cost factor. You know, it's kind of a race to the bottom with these things. Who can sell them the cheapest? That sort of thing. But don't think this one is any safer. And my experience has also been, the higher the quality of one of these, the more prone it is to an accident, because it's made to really go off when any current hits it. And when I say any current, I'm talking about just this. Just something that simple of a voltage. All right, let's test this shunting out in theory and unshunt it and see if it works. Okay, here it is right here. We're using a regulated match. Now that looks to be shunted. So let's test it out. Now, I'm not sure how well I shunted it, but we're going to find out. And when I touch it, you should not hear a pop. It popped. See, it wasn't shunted well enough. Now let's take a little closer look at it. Now, I did this shunt, not the company. No, it wasn't shunted. Let's try another one. Okay, this is my creation again, and I'm going to figure a way to test just how it would come from the factory. I'll have to put extensions on it. Okay, now I shunted that myself. Let's test it. Okay, I must have got it that time. Won't work. I'm on it. Now let's unshunt it. Open. Back. Same position. And it goes. You get the principle of that? Shunted, unshunted. Now actually, if you really want to be sure, you would do this. You know, kind of twist it real good to be certain. Now let me test one. Now that's me doing it. Let me test one of theirs, just how they would do it at random. Okay, here's a random grab of four Chinese electric match. Let's see if we could see. See, the problem with me, if I would strip the ends of those wires, I would disturb what they did. So I can't really scientifically do that. But we could examine their shunting. You know, is it shunted? Isn't it? It's a little shaky. That's one. Here's another random. Just right out of the box. Right out of the box. So what do you think? It's making the ones with the cover on them, making you a little more confident that it's shunted. See, if you have the cover on it, you know, a little more assurance that it is shunted. And then you get the debris fire with the cap, and it's even more shunted. So it may or may not even be shunted. Okay, let's assume that 20 to 40% of them are not going to be shunted. That's my take. The upside is that the end of the wire is not exposed. So the current's going to have to jump right in that little gap, you know, somewhere to be a problem. Okay, now, are these initiators shock sensitive, the same as a regular electric match? I say they are, and let's test it. Okay, we have regular electric match and some of the initiators. You know, people that sometimes watch my videos, they see me pull that cover back, and they get nervous sometimes, you know, like, hey, it's a... You know, you're gonna watch, it's sensitive. You know, here's the cover that's normally on them. The choice whether to pull the cover back is yours. No fireworks company in the country is ever gonna tell you to take that cover back. Just so you know, I have mixed feelings about it, because back in the day we took the cover off all the time before there were ports and the electric match was tight. We would take the cover, put it into each shell, do barges and barges and days of it. All right, let's see. And I have some eye protection and gloves. That's the real one. Real one again. Just, let's see if I got a lighter. It sparks. What you have to watch is, if you have a cake that you fused, and a lot of cakes are fused on the top, and there's actually some countries that have a regulation that all consumer products have to be fused on the top. So when you do that and you're transporting and you pick one cake up and stack one on the other, this is how it sometimes happens. All right, let's try one of the initiators. No, it didn't, see? Another initiator. We'll give it a good hit this time. See, it went. It's hit and miss. The real one. Real one. That's how accidents happen, right there. Just for the heck of it, let me get one with the cover on it and give it a try. Okay, just so you can see, they're both good at the start here. Cover. Yeah, cover. That one here. Get some distance on it here. Try to do it with the same force. Took the cover off. Interesting. Does help. Okay, you can draw your own conclusions. Now you see what the risk is. Just keep in mind that the blue and white wire initiators carry the same risk as the traditional ones. All right, everyone, I hope you enjoyed this video.